let's stand on and say a prayer. Father, we just come to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus, God. We thank you for this opportunity, God. God, we thank you, God, that your word is truth, Father God. God, I appreciate you talking to me in your word, God, as I studied this message, Father God. I thank you for the man of God of this house, God. I thank you, God, for the woman of God and every member of this household of faith, Father. And Father God, as I go forth, Father God, you be glorified. You be edified in this message, Father. And I thank you. I give you praise. I give you glory. And it is in the name of Jesus. Everybody say, amen. Amen. I tell you, people of God, you know, you can be somewhere for a long time and still be jacked up. And I said jacked up. Yeah, that's what I mean. You can be jacked up. You can be tore up from the floor up. And it's a bad thing to be in a situation like that and don't even know it. That's even bad. And so God had gave me this, and I've been in this for a long time, and this was for me. And I believe if you have an ear to hear, it'll be a blessing unto you.
All right.
And if you got your Bible, turn to Genesis 27, and we're going to start with the 38th verse. Genesis 27 and 38. And when you get there, say amen. The word of God is read as following. And Esau said unto his father, "Hast thou but one blessing, my father? Bless me also, O my father." And Esau lifted up his voice and wept. And Isaac his father answered and said unto him, "Behold, thy dwelling shall be the fatness of the earth and of the dew of heaven from above. And by the sword shall thou live, and shall serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck." The 41st verse. And Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewithin his father blessed him. And Esau said in his heart, "The days of mourning for my father is at hand. Then will I slay my brother Jacob." Amen?
Amen.
One more scripture, and we're going to get into the message. You can turn to Galatians 5 and 1.
My God.
Galatians 5 and 1. The word of God is read as following. "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty wherewith Christ has made us free. Be not entangled again with the yoke of bondage."
Yes, amen.
Amen?
Amen. That's it, right there.
I thank God for the woman of God of this house, Dr. J. E. Hughes.
Amen.
I want y'all to go back in memory lane and just look at some of the topics that she has brought forth through certain people. Uh-huh. Now remember that some months ago we talked about positive confessions.
Yeah, all right. All right.
Remember she had someone talks about the different names of God. And then she began to talk about an inheritance.
Yes.
Now we all been having a strong spirit.
Yes.
Don't you know that God is speaking into this house?
Yes.
There is some things that he wants us to do in this time.
Yes.
Because the man of God said of this house, Dr. William Hughes, said that there's coming, something coming to this country.
Yes.
And we got to be ready for this.
Yes.
Because when this thing comes, if you ain't rooted and grounded in God, you ain't going to be able to stand.
Come on.
So we're going to look here of a man of God named Esau. And there's four people we want to look at in this message. We want to talk about Isaac. We want to talk about his wife Rebecca. And we want to talk about Esau and Jacob.
Yeah.
Now there was other folks involved in this, but these are the four characters that we want to look at.
Yeah.
So let's go back to Genesis again. We're going to break this thing down, all right? Genesis. Let's go to Genesis 27. and 38. Now, you got to understand, you got to go back even further to really understand this. Now, the Bible says that Rebecca was pregnant.
Come on.
And there were some things going on the inside of her that she didn't quite understand.
Okay.
So she inquired of the Lord about what's going on here. And God told her these words, I'm going to paraphrase, and it ain't worded exactly, but you go back and you read it, okay?
That's all right.
But God told her, said, you got two nations in your womb.
Yes.
And he said, these nations are the oldest is going to serve the youngest.
Yes, yes, my God.
And he said that. Now, if you go back and read it real closely, you're going to see also that, she inquired of the Lord. But nowhere in the scripture you saw what she told her husband what the Lord said.
Right.
Nowhere in the scripture.
Okay.
Now, the man of God, Esau, well, let's go back. Let's talk about the daddy first. So, what? Isaac. Now, Isaac was the son of Abraham. Now, you know the story about Abraham.
Okay.
You know how he left his family and stuff. You know what God said, told him to do.
Right.
And he had a wife that couldn't have no child.
Right.
So he prayed. And God said that she was going to have a child.
Amen.
Now God told him and her about Isaac.
Yeah.
Both of them knew. Because even they said, when he told the man of God, she was laughing on the inside. She was laughing about it. How can it be? You know, I'm old, I'm going to have a baby. So the story went on that God told him to sacrifice his son.
All
right. Man, that's why it's so important in this hour, folks, that any church won't do.
Right.
You got to be somewhere where there's a real man and woman of God.
Yeah.
Somebody that's really standing on the word of God.
Yeah.
It may look silly, it may look stupid. And I just want to start right now. Pastor Hughes, I want to thank you.
Thank you.
I've been in this church for a long time, and even right now, Pastor still pushing me.
Yeah,
man. See, there's some things that I really don't want to do.
Come on.
But my God, God knows.
Yeah.
Because see, if I don't get pushed, because see, right now, purpose and destiny is going on in my life right now.
Oh,
there's some things God has already spoken about me, and there's some untold things He has said about me that I have no idea about.
Yeah.
But I thank God that the man of God sees something beyond this natural man, Earl Calloway.
Yes.
Baby, I thank you for pushing me.
Yes.
I thank you when I want to give up. You said, Mama, you've been standing there. I said, man, you know how sometimes, you know, us being pastors say, you want to quit.
Yeah.
You said, man, forget this. Why do I have to go take all of this?
Yes.
Why do I got to take this?
Yes.
Why I got to listen to all of this stuff?
Yes, come on. Preach.
Come on.
If I begin to shout and run around, y'all look over me because y'all just don't know what God is doing in this hour. You just don't know. You're looking on with your natural eyes, but let's get in the spirit.
Yeah. Come on.
So, I know Pastor Man, sometimes some of the things that he be saying just sound ridiculous.
Yes.
Right.
Let's go. So we see here, God told Abraham to sacrifice his son.
Right.
And Abraham was going to do that very thing. And here's Isaac. We're going to talk about him a little bit more.
Come on.
And he looked around and said, man, where's the land? Where's the guy? And you say, well, where is it? And the words were said, God will provide.
Yeah.
How many know sometimes when you're on your very last hope, God will provide some things for you? And that he was going to be led by his younger brother.
Right.
And the Bible also said that Esau despised his birthright. Now here you got a man despising his birthright. You got a man here that his mother and brother deceived his daddy.
Wow.
What is God in all of this, y'all? It don't seem like God is in the midst of this, but God was already. I tell you what, God, now, did they have to do it like that? No, they didn't. Because when God says some things and we do, we see that now. You know how we want to help God out.
Even his
granddaddy wanted to help God out. Sarah, you know, she said, well, since I can't have no baby, I'll take my handmaid. You don't see the word where Abraham said, no, I don't want this woman. In the power of God. And before I go, I want at least four females over here, and I'm going to call your name out. Nancy, I want you to get Ephesians 3:20. Sister Ben, I want you to get Ephesians 4:29. The sister in the back, Sister Ricky. Cynthia, can you get Jeremiah 29:11? And then I need somebody to get Sister Thieves Anderson. Get Luke 22, verses 31 and 32.
All right.
Okay? Now we want to look at something here. Now I may call you out when I begin to elaborate on this, to read one of those scriptures. But here Esau, man, this man was, man, messed up. Man, he was hurt. Man, hear this man now. Yeah, he despised his birthright, man. But that's where you got everybody say, but God. Sometimes folks will rate you off and say you ain't nothing.
Come on.
But God still have purpose and destiny in your life.
Yeah.
It ain't what it looks like. It's what God has already predestined in your life.
Yeah.
Sometimes I'm telling you, even in the midst of stuff that looks real bad, we're going to see here, well, Isaac said these words. He said, no, he spoke something into Jacob's life.
Right.
He spoke a word.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And he said, I can't take it back.
Mm-hmm.
In the midst of all of this deceitfulness, all of the lies,
Come on.
The word of God went forth.
Yes.
And he said, I can't take it back.
Yes.
What I said is what's going to happen.
That's it.
And then here Esau said, do you have another blessing for me? Ephesians 4:29. Read that. Read that, please.
Let no corrupt word proceed out of your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
But what is good?
What is what?
Good.
Okay.
For necessary edification, that it may impart grace to the hearers.
Mm.
Yeah. Now, you know how some of us get in a bad situation, man. We want to say some bad things.
Yeah.
And the natural man, he probably had right to say, why did y'all do that? Why did y'all do that? He had the right to probably speak some evil stuff. He probably had the right to cuss you out. But the man of God walking in the power of God, that strong spirit that the woman of God been talking about, walking in the Holy Ghost.
Come on,
you're going to know who you are when trials and tribulations done spoke too many things in my life that I needed to know for myself. I don't take this title as a bishop lightly.
Come on, man.
Because see, a title means something. That's an office that God has established. Are you going to work operating that title?
Yes.
It's more than just having a name.
That's right.
Come on, come on, bishop.
It's something goes with that thing.
Yeah.
blessing and a birthright.
Come on,
let me just give you the definition of birthright. Okay? Now, birthright, normally the oldest or the firstborn gets special privileges within a family.
All right.
Okay, you receive not only natural blessings, but spiritual. And sometimes you get more than what everybody else gets. Okay? Now, blessing. Now, there's so many blessings about God that I can't talk about them all.
Yeah.
But there's a couple that we want to talk about. Because Esau and Jacob, Esau was operating in anger.
Come on.
And this was a real thing. He was going to kill his brother.
Yes.
That was, he was going to kill his brother.
Right.
Well, no doubt about it, he was going to do it. What happened before? Cain and Abel, you know the story. So he was going to kill his brother. But the man of God, operating in the power and the strength of the Spirit, said, "And thou shalt break his yoke off your neck." So he knew at some point in time in the future that yoke was going to come off. Now, Esau ain't heard nothing. And he goes right there and look at the, let's jump down to 41 verse. After all that that went forth, this is what Esau said. Esau hated Jacob because of the blessing wherewith his father blessed him. Now, here it is now. How many of y'all going to speak evil of your parents? Listen to what Esau was saying. He said in his heart, and that's a problem that we're having. We're having some heart problems.
Okay, that's it.
He said these words here. He said in his heart, "The days of mourning for my father at hand, then will I slay my brother Jacob." He meant that. He was going to kill him. But his mother, God had already spoken that thing. That thing was going to happen, man. Jacob was going to get the blessing. They didn't have to do all of that.
Right.
So his mother said, "Leave." Now, we're talking about Esau, but there were some other folks that had some yokes. Now, believe it or not, Jacob had a yoke. And we're going to get ready to close because, man, it's so much in there. I can't finish this. I can't finish it all. It's just so much in there. But Jacob had a yoke around his neck because he knew what his brother said he was going to do there. So his mother sent him to her brother's house, Laman. And when he got there, he seen this beautiful woman named Rachel. Sometimes you reap what you sow, y'all. He was so deceived with his brother Esau. He went to Laban's house. Guess what happened to him? He reaped some stuff. Esau raised a man. He wanted that woman. So he said, "Man, look, I'll work for 7 years." But those 7 years seemed like 7 days to him, man, because he wanted that. And he worked 7 years. And then Laban said, "No, we don't do it like that. Hey, Leah is the oldest child, so you need to marry her first." And so, man, you know the story. Here's a man worth 14 years to get a woman. Now, after 14 years, it could have been a little bit longer. He still had that yoke on his neck about his brother killing him. So if you go on down to, I think, the 33rd verse, you'll see where God told him to leave there, okay? And he went back. He wanted to beat his brother and all that stuff. But this is where, this is how you know he had a yoke on his neck. Because he told his servant, "Go," and he got all this stuff together. They said, give this to my brother and call him Lord. He said, "Call him Lord." He said, "Give him all of this stuff." And so when he did, he said, "Now I'm going to put Rachel." You know who his son was? His son was Joseph. He had a son named Joseph. You know what's going to happen with Joseph, y'all. You're going to see, if you read these verses, you're going to see stuff kind of repeat itself. It's going to repeat itself. So he put them all in the back. He said, "If he's going to attack me, they'll be the last one that they'll get." So he did that. But what's so good about about it, God had removed the yoke from Esau's neck.
Yes, sir.
He didn't want to kill his brother anymore.
Amen.
And guess what? Esau had enough stuff.
Yes,
he didn't want his stuff.
Right.
Didn't need his stuff.
Right.
All right? And we're going to close with this. If you get a chance, read the rest of this. But we want to close with, who did I tell to read Luke 22?
Luke 22, 31 and 32. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan had desired to have you, that he may shift you as wheat. But I have prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brother.
Man, you can't do that, man. Sometimes, but God, when God's in the midst, for with God, nothing shall be impossible.
Yeah. Right.
But as a natural man, you cannot do it, anything for anybody you can't do for self.
Amen.
So God was telling the man of God, man, when you get yourself together.
Yes.
Yes.
All right.
Get in power with the Holy Ghost.
Yes. Yes. Come on.
Know me a little bit there.
Yes. Yes.
Then when you do all of that, help your brother.
Yes. Yes.
Jeremiah 29:11. Who has that?
For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace,
peace,
not of evil, to give you an expected end.
God wants us to operate in that peace, y'all.
Yes,
man.
Yes,
man, I mean, when you talk, worry, and concern about that, man, those are yours.
Yes, yes, yes.
Man, God don't want us to be yoked down like that. What you want to do? No, I ain't talking about that. That ain't what I want to. So
yes.
The devil said that you are a liar.
Yes.
I'm talking about being free in God.
Yes.
Being in the midst of a storm and have some joy.